Dear students, in this lecture we are going to see the last part of unit 5, that is dynamics of particles. We are going to see about the principle of impulse and momentum. In the last two lectures we have seen how to solve the dynamic equilibrium problems using D'Alembert's principle and also by using principle of work and energy, or by using work energy equation. So here we are going to see another method of solving dynamic equilibrium problems, that is principle of impulse and so the contents what we are going to see in this particular lecture are the basic definitions of impulse and momentum. Then we are going to see how to derive the impulse momentum equation. Then we are going to see how this impulse momentum method can be used for solving problems on motion of connected bodies, and we are going to see some of the solved problems using impulse momentum equation. Now let us see first of all what is meant by impulse. So as per the definition, impulse acting on a body is measured by the product of force acting on the body and the time for which it acts. So by definition, impulse is equal to force into time. So the force is F and time is T. So if you see the unit of impulse, since the unit of force is Newton and the unit for time is seconds, the unit for impulse will be Newton second, and this impulse is going to be a vector quantity. So the impulse is simply defined as the product of force and the time. Then we have another term which is called as impulsive force. So this impulsive force is nothing but when you have a larger magnitude of force where it acts on the body for a very shorter duration of time, that force can be defined as an impulsive force. So the best examples are the cricket ball hit by a bat and the football kicked by a player, etc. So now here the first case, the body is going to be a cricket ball, so which is hit by the bat. So you have a large force which is developed in the cricket ball by the bat. And similarly in the second case, you have the football which is kicked by a player. So here the football is the body and you have the large force exerted on this ball by the player. So these two forces, in both the cases the forces, they are going to act only for a shorter duration of time. So such kind of force we call it as an impulsive force. Then we'll see what is meant by momentum. So this momentum is also called as linear momentum. It is defined as the product of mass and velocity. So it is simply m into v. And if you see the unit of momentum, so it is the, since it is a product of mass and velocity, the unit for momentum will be kg meter per second, or it is also called as Newton second. Now let us see how to derive the impulse momentum equation. So here if you see this particular principle, this principle can be used for solving problems where you have force, velocity and time are involved. So now you consider a body and you assume that you have a force F acting on a body. So the mass of the body is M, and this force is acting on a body over a time interval of T1 and T2. Now again we are going to derive this impulse momentum equation from Newton's law of motion, that is Newton's second law of motion we are going to apply. So from Newton's second law of motion, we know that F is equal to M into A. And since this acceleration is rate of change of velocity, this equation can be rewritten as F is equal to M into dV by dt. Now, if you bring this dt to the left hand side, you'll get F into dt is equal to M into dV. Now, we are going to integrate both sides. Since the time interval is T1 to T2, the left hand side, we're going to integrate between the limit T1 and T2. And since in the right hand side, the velocity is the going to vary from u to v, where u is the initial velocity and v is the final velocity. Therefore, in the right hand side, the integration limit is u to v. So when you integrate this particular equation, so we get integral t1 to t2 is in f dt is equal to, so when you integrate this, you get integral dv is nothing but v. Then when you substitute the limits of u and v, so we get m into v minus m into u. So this mv minus mu, since it's nothing but the change in momentum, because we know that momentum is the product of mass and velocity. So here this is v is the final velocity and u is the initial velocity. Therefore this mv is called as final momentum and mu is called as initial momentum. Therefore we get mv minus mu is nothing but final momentum minus initial momentum, which is also called as change in momentum. And if you take the left hand side, this integral t1 to t2 f into dt, so this is called as impulse. So since this is a product of force and time, so we call it as impulse. So this left hand side, we call it as impulse. So from this we get from the Newton's second law of motion, so we have derived this particular
equation, and this equation is called as impulse momentum equation or the principle of impulse and momentum. So according to this principle, we have impulse is equal to change in momentum, which is equal to final momentum minus initial momentum. So this equation we are going to use for solving the problems on dynamic equilibrium of particles, or we can analyze the system of motion of connected bodies using this impulse momentum principle. Now coming to motion of connected bodies, again, as I said previously, the motion of connected bodies can be solved by impulse momentum equation. So as we know, the system is going to be consisting of more than two bodies, so which may be connected by cables or strings or some cords or some pulleys also. So in that case, for such kind of problems, we can use impulse momentum equations for solving the problems. And suppose if you have more than one body, and if the connected bodies are having same velocity, then we can consider the free body diagram of the combined system. So and here we can neglect the internal force like tension in the string, because they used to cancel each other when you take a combined system. And so if the connected bodies are having same velocity, then we are going to draw the free body diagram of the combined system, and we are going to apply the impulse momentum equation in the direction of motion of the connected bodies. So first we have to identify the direction of the motion of the connected bodies. So after identifying the direction of motion of the connected bodies, so when the connected bodies are still having the same velocity, then we are going to take the free body diagram of the combined system, and for that combined system we are going to apply the impulse momentum equation. On the other hand, suppose if the connected bodies are moving with different velocities, so in that case the free body diagram of each body we have to consider separately, and for each free body diagram you have to apply the impulse momentum equation in the direction of motion of the connected bodies. So here the tension in the strings or cables or cords or whatever internal force it has, that has to be considered while you draw the free body diagram. Now with this background, let us try to see some of the problems using the impulse momentum principle. So the first problem is, you have a 2000 kg automobile moving with a velocity of 0.8 meter per second, hits a wall and is brought to rest in 15 × 10⁻³ seconds. Determine the average impulsive force exerted by the wall on the car during the impact. So you have to find here the average impulsive force which is exerted by the wall on the car. So here the data given is, you have the mass, that is M, which is 2000 kg, that is the mass of the automobile. It is moving with a velocity of 0.8 meter per second, therefore the initial velocity is 0.8 meter per second, and it hits a wall and it brought to rest, therefore the final velocity is 0, therefore V is equal to 0, and the time is given as 15 × 10⁻³ seconds, therefore T is given. And you have to find the impulsive force exerted by the wall on the car during impact. So we know the impulse momentum equation, that is impulse is equal to change in momentum. So from this we are going to get the average impulsive force exerted by the wall, since we know that impulse is the product of force and the time. So here it is a net force acting on the body, so that's why it is given as summation fx. So summation fx is nothing but the net force in the direction of the motion of the body. Now if you you assume that P is the impulsive force exerted by the wall, and here this P is taken as negative, because this impulsive force which is exerted by the wall, it acts in the direction opposite to the motion of the automobile, because your automobile is going to move in the forward direction, whereas the impulsive force exerted by the wall will be acting in the opposite direction of the motion of the automobile. Therefore this P will be negative. Therefore this P we are going to find out, since we know the impulse momentum equation, impulse is the product of force and the time. The force is taken as minus P into time is given, 15 × 10⁻³ seconds, and change in momentum is nothing but mv minus mu, and here initial velocity is given as 0.8 meter per second, and the final velocity is 0 since it is brought to rest. So after substituting all the values, we get the impulsive force as 32,000 newton, or it is also called as, or it is also written as 32 kilonewton. Now moving to the second problem, so here you have a motorcycle of mass 120 kg, it's traveling on a horizontal road at 54 km per hour. Find the time required to stop the motorcycle if the coefficient of friction between the tires and the road is 0.4. So you have a motorcycle, the mass is given as 120 kg, so you have to calculate the weight, so which is 120 × 9.81, which is acting downwards, And since it is moving in a horizontal rod, and since the frictional force will also be there, the coefficient of friction is given as 0.4. So you have the frictional force also. So which F is equal to mu into R. So this frictional force will be acting in a direction opposite to the direction of the motion. So since the motorcycle is moving in this direction, the frictional force will be acting in this direction, which is 0.4 into R. And you have a normal reaction also, which is represented as R. And we know that impulse momentum equation, that is force into time. So summation Fx into t, that is impulse is equal to change in momentum. And the initial velocity is given as 54 km per hour. So you have to convert that to a meter per second. So when you convert this, you will get 15 meter per second. Now you have to find the net force in the direction of the motion. That is summation Fx is nothing but net force along the direction of the motion. So if you see the forces acting in the direction of the motion, so you have only the frictional force, which is acting opposite to the direction of the motion. Therefore, it is minus mu into R. So next thing is you have to find this normal reaction. So for this, you consider the free body diagram and you apply the equations of equilibrium. So in order to get this normal reaction R, you are applying summation Fy equal to 0. When you apply summation Fy equal to 0, you get R minus 120 into 9.81. So from this, R is equal to this. After getting this value of R, you substitute back in this equation in order to get the net force in the direction of the motion. So we got the net force is 470.9 Newton. After getting this, you substitute in the impulse momentum equation. So from this, we get the time required to stop the motorcycle as 3.82 seconds. Now the next problem is again a very simple problem. So you have a 1500 Newton block which is in contact with a level plane, and the coefficient of friction is given, that is 0.1. If the block is acted upon by a horizontal force of 300 Newton, what time it will elapse before the block reaches a velocity of 16 meter per second starting from rest? So the system starts from rest, therefore your u will be equal to 0. And the question is, you have to find the time taken in order to reach the velocity of 16 meter per second when it starts from rest. So that is the question. Again, we are going to start from the impulse momentum equation. So impulse is change in momentum. So impulse is product of force into time. This is the net force in the direction of the motion. So if you calculate the net force in the direction of the motion, so your block is going to move in this direction. Therefore, the net force in the direction of the motion will be 300 minus you have the frictional force, that is mu into R, that is 0.1 into R. Now, in order to get the normal reaction R, again, we consider the free body diagram of the block. So here, you have the horizontal force, you have the normal reaction, you have the frictional force, you have the self weight. Now, if you apply summation Fy equal to 0, then you get R minus 1500 is equal to 0. So we get R is equal to 1500 Newton. After substituting this value of R in the previous equation of net force, so we get the net force in the direction of the motion as 150 Newton. Then finally, we are going to substitute in the impulse momentum equation to get the time taken by the block to reach a velocity of 16 meter per second. So here the initial velocity is 0, the final velocity will be 16 meter per second. So for this, we need to calculate the time taken. So time taken is 16.31 seconds. Now the next problem, you have the two blocks of masses 280 kg and 420 kg which are connected as shown in figure. Assume that the pulley is frictionless and mu is equal to 0.3 between the block A and the surface. If the system is initially at rest, determine the velocity of the blocks after 3 seconds. So you have to calculate the velocity of the blocks at a time of or after a time of 3 seconds. And here the masses of the blocks are given in kilograms. So first you have to convert that to Newton by multiplying by 9.81. So the mass of the block A is 2746.8 Newton and the mass of the block B is 4120.2 Newton, and the coefficient of friction is given as 0.3, that is between the block A and the floor or surface, and given as 0.3, and the time is 3 seconds and the initial velocity is 0 because the system is starting from rest. Now with this data, you have to find the velocity of the blocks after 3 seconds. Again, we are going to make use of the impulse momentum principle. So according to this principle, impulse is equal to change in momentum, that is summation Fx into t is equal to mv minus mu. And here both the blocks act as a single system, and therefore this block B is going to move down and the block A is going to move in the right direction. So Now let us calculate the net force in the direction of the motion. So for that, let us consider the free body diagram of the two blocks. So for the first block, this is the free body diagram. So you have the self weight, then you have the tension in the cable, then you have the normal reaction, then you have the frictional force. Whereas if you take this particular block B, you have only self weight and you have the tension in the cable. So these are the free body diagrams of the two blocks. Now if you calculate the net force in the direction of the motion, so the net force will be, so this block is going to move towards right. So the net force will be plus T, then minus 0.3 R, plus T minus 0.3 R. Now if you take this block is going to move in this direction. So the net force in the direction of the motion will be equal to, so this force, it is 420 into 9.81, which is 4120.2, then minus T. So here this minus T, and for this block you have plus T. So this plus T and minus T will get cancelled each other. Therefore, in the resultant equation, you don't have T. So simply the net force will be equal to, you have this 0.3 R, and similarly here you have this self weight. That's all. So this is the net force in the direction of the motion. So please clearly understand. So this T here, it is plus. If you take this block, the net force in the direction of the motion, it will be minus T. Therefore, this plus T and minus T will get cancelled each other. And therefore, in this equation, you don't have any T. Now, in order to get the normal reaction, you have to again apply equations of equilibrium. That is, you have to resolve the forces normal to the plane. So, from that, we get the normal reaction as R. This value, and after substituting this R value in the net force equation, we get the net force is 3296.16 Newton. Then finally, we are applying the impulse momentum equation to get the velocity of the block, and we need to get the tension also. So for that, you can apply impulse momentum equation on any one body. So now we have taken this block B. So for this block B, you have only these two forces, that is self weight and the tension. So when you apply the impulse momentum equation for this particular block, that is net force in the direction of the motion will be 420 into 9.81 minus T into time is 3 seconds. So when you apply this equation, we get the tension in the string as 2142 Newton. So while solving this problem, you please understand that. So initially, we need to find the velocity of the block by considering the system as a whole, or by applying the impulse momentum equation for the combined system. Whereas if you want to find the tension in the cable, you can take any one of the blocks and you can apply the impulse momentum equation for that particular block to get the tension in the string. And the next problem, you have a block which is resting on an inclined plane. So the weight of the block is 1200 Newton. So the angle of inclination of this plane is 20 degrees. Now it is pulled up the plane. Therefore, this block is going to move upwards, and this block is going to move downwards. So this is the system, and the coefficient of friction is given between the block A and the plane is given as 0.2. So you have to get the velocity of the system after 1.5 seconds. So now, since the system starts from rest, the initial velocity will be equal to 0. Now let us consider the free body diagrams of each of the blocks. So for the block which is resting in an inclined plane, so you have the self weight 1200 Newton, which is resolved into two components, 1200 sine 20, that is along the plane, and 1200 cos 20 perpendicular to the plane. And since it is resting in a surface, you have the normal reaction R, then you have the tension T in the cable, then you have the frictional force F, which is equal to mu into R. This frictional force is acting in this direction because this block is going to move in this direction. And if you consider the free body diagram of the second block, you have the self weight and also you have the tension in the string. Now we are going to apply the impulse momentum equation. So for that, you need to find the net force in the direction of the motion. So if you calculate the net force in the direction of the motion, so you have plus T, then minus 1200 sine 20, then minus 0.2 R. Similarly, if you take this block, you have plus 800, then minus T. So this plus T and minus T will get cancelled each other. Therefore, the resultant force will become this. So after simplification, you get an equation like this. Now we need to get the normal reaction R. So in order to get the normal, you consider the free body diagram of this block and you resolve the forces normal to the plane. So when you resolve the forces normal to the plane, you get R minus 1200 cos 20 is equal to 0. From this, you get the value of R. After getting this normal reaction, your resultant force will now become this. Now, after substituting the impulse momentum equation, we get the velocity of the block as 1.21 meter per second. Now, the next problem is you have the two blocks. Both the blocks are resting on an inclined plane. So, here the 20 kg block is resting on an inclined plane. The angle of inclination of the plane is 30 degree. And you have the another block, 40 kg, which is resting on an inclined surface. The angle of inclination of the inclined surface here is 60 degree. Now, the coefficient of friction is given as 0.3 for both this surface as well as this surface. So, for this condition, you have to find the velocity of the block after 5 seconds starting from rest. So, again, since the block weights are given, mass is given, so you have to convert that into weight first of all. So, 20 into 9.81, similarly 40 into 9.81, so you get the weight of the blocks. After getting the weight of the blocks, you need to draw the free body diagram of each of the blocks. So, for this block, 20 kg block, so this is the free body diagram. Self weight is 196.2, again resolved into two components. Then you have the tension T in the string, then you have the frictional force, you have the normal reaction. Similarly, for this block, since it is going to move in this direction, it is going to move down. So, you have frictional force like this. You have the normal reaction again. You have the self weight, again, which is resolved into two components like this. Then you have the tension in the string. So, these are the free body diagrams. Now, apply the impulse momentum equation. So, again, the free body diagrams are shown here. So, here the impulses change in momentum. So, now we have to find the net force in the direction of the motion. So, the net force will be equal to, so this block is going to move up and this block is going to move down. So, if you calculate the net force in the direction of the motion, so let us start from here, 392.4 sine 60, then you have minus 0.3 RB, then you have minus T. If you consider this block, the net force in the direction of the motion will be plus T, then minus 0.3 RA, then minus 196.2 sine 30. This plus T and minus T will be cancelled. Therefore, the resultant equation will be this. After simplification, you get an equation like this. Now, in order to find RA and RB, you have to again resolve the forces normal to the plane for both the blocks. So, for block A, when you resolve the forces normal to the plane, you get RA is this. You can resolve the forces normal to the plane and you can get the value of RB. So, after getting the normal reactions RA and RB, you can substitute in the net force equation to get the net force as 131.297 Newton. Then after that, you have to apply in the impulse momentum equation. So, net force is this. Time is given as 5 seconds. Then, you have this equation to find out the velocity is 11 meter per second. Now, this is the next problem. You have two blocks A and B of weight 16 Newton and 14 Newton, which are connected by a string passing through a smooth pulley as shown in figure. Find the velocity of the block after 3 seconds starting from rest. So, you have the weights of the blocks are given. So, one block is weighing 16 Newton, another block is weighing 14 Newton. So, since this weight of the block A is more than weight of the block B, so this block A is going to move downwards, whereas the block B is going to move upwards. Now, when you apply the, when you draw the free body diagram, so for this block 16 Newton, you have the self weight, you have the tension. Similarly, for the 40 Newton block, you have the self weight, you have the tension in the string. So, when you apply the impulse momentum equation, so we know that impulse is change in momentum. So, impulse is the product of the net force and the time. So, net force is nothing but, so net force in the direction of your motion is 60 minus 40, which is equal to 20 Newton. Now, substituting in the impulse momentum equation, so we get the velocity as 5.89 meter per second. Now, in order to find the tension in the string, you can apply the impulse momentum equation for any one body. So, when you apply the impulse momentum equation for this 40 Newton block, so you get the net force in the direction of the motion will be T minus 40 and the time is 3 seconds. Then again, mass is this. So, from this, we get the tension in the string as 48.01. Newton. Now here in the next problem you have the two weights 200 Newton and 70 Newton which are connected by a string and which is passing over a frictionless pulley. But here, if you see this particular system, the velocity of the two blocks will not be equal because the 70 newton block, it is connected by a single string, whereas if you take the 200 newton block, it will be connected by two strings as shown in the figure. But the total length of the string is constant, therefore 2SA plus SB is equal to constant. So when you differentiate this, 2VA plus VB is equal to 0, or VB is equal to minus 2VA, and this VB is positive, that is it is moving upward, and this VA is negative because the block B, block A moves downwards. And since the blocks are starting from rest, both UA and UB will be equal to 0. Now you consider the 200 newton block. So this is the free body diagram. So you have the self weight, then you have the tension in the strings, which are marked as T here. When you apply the impulse momentum equation, so now you please understand that since the velocities of the blocks are different here, so we consider the free body diagram for each block separately, and for each of the blocks we need to apply the impulse momentum equation. So for this 200 newton block, we are applying the impulse momentum equation. So for this, we are finding out the net force in the direction of the motion. So net force will be 200 minus 2 into T. So since you have 2 T's, so 200 minus 2t into time is 1.5, and you have to find out the mass. Therefore, you are converting this weight to mass divided by 9.81 into the final velocity minus the initial velocity is 0. So from this, we get a equation like this. Consider the second block, 70 newton block. Again, we are applying the impulse momentum equation. You are finding the net force in the direction of the motion. So if you find the net force in the direction of the motion, so the direction of the motion is upwards here. Therefore, T minus 70 into 1.5. Again, you are converting this mass, weight to mass, therefore divided by 9.81. And VB is equal to 2VA. We know that already. So from that, we get an equation like this. So after solving the equations, we get VA and VB as this. So also, we can find out the tension from the equations. So we get the tension as 87.5 newton. And this is another simple problem. You have the two blocks, 200 newton and 800 newton, which are connected by a thread, and it is resting on a horizontal plane, rough horizontal plane, and you have a horizontal force also, 400 newton, and the coefficient of friction is given, that is 0.3 between the blocks and the surface, and you have to find the velocity of the system after time t 2 seconds, and also you have to find the tension in the string using the impulse momentum equation. And because of this force 400 newton, both the bodies will move towards right, and both the bodies will be moving with the same velocity. Therefore, since the blocks are going to move with the same velocity, then we can consider this as a single system, and then we can apply the impulse momentum equation for the single system. Now you consider the free body diagram of this block. So you have the self weight, you have the tension, you have the normal reaction, similarly you have the frictional force. And the second block, you have the applied force, you have the normal reaction, you have the tension, then you have the frictional force, you have the self weight. So these are the free body diagrams. Now we are going to apply the impulse momentum equation for a single system, for the system as a whole. So that means you have to find the net force in the direction of the motion. So the net force in the direction of the motion will be 400, then minus t, then minus 0.3 R1. If you consider this block, the net force in the direction of the motion will be plus t minus 0.3 R2. So this minus t and plus t will get cancelled each there. Therefore, in the resultant net force, you don't have t. Now, in order to get the normal reactions R1 and R2, you have to consider the free body diagrams of each block separately, and you have to resolve the forces normal to the plane. So for 800 newton block, if you resolve the forces normal to the plane, you get R1. Minus 800 is equal to 0. From this, we get R1 is equal to 800. Similarly, in order to get the R2, you have to use the free body diagram of this particular. So when you do that, you get the R2 value as 200. Then you can find the net force in the direction of the motion as this. Then you can apply in the impulse momentum equation. So net force in the direction of the motion into time is 2 seconds is given. Then the mass into the final velocity minus 0. So from this, the velocity of the system is obtained as 1.96 meter per second. And in order to find out t, you can consider the free body diagram of any one block, and you can apply the impulse momentum equation. Now here we are considering 200 newton block. So for this block, when you apply the impulse momentum equation, the net force in the direction of the motion will be equal to t minus 0.3 into R2. So the time is 2 seconds. So from this, we are getting the value of tension as 80 newton. Now this is another problem. So you have two blocks, 500 newton and 1000 newton, which is shown here, and the coefficient of friction is given as 0.3. That is, for this block, the coefficient of friction between the 500 newton block and the inclined plane is given as 0.3. So you have to get the velocity of the block after 3 seconds starting from rest, and assume pulleys to be weightless and frictionless. Now this block B is going to move downward, and the block A moves up the plane, and here the velocities of the blocks will not be different, because here the block B is supported by two strings, whereas the block A is supported by a single string. Therefore, the velocities of the blocks will not be constant. Therefore, these blocks will be moving with different velocities. In such a case, you have to draw the free body diagram of each of the blocks separately, and for each of the block you have to apply the impulse momentum equation. So here in this particular problem, the two blocks will be moving with different velocities, but the total length of the string is constant. Therefore, we get a equation like this, and also when you differentiate this, we get VA plus 2VB equal to 0. So from this, VA is equal to minus 2VB. Now you consider the free body diagram of 500 newton block. So you have the self weight, again, which is resolved into two components, 500 cos 30 and 500 sin 30. You have the normal reaction R, you have the frictional force F, then you have the tension T. Now you apply the impulse momentum equation for this block. So for this, we are calculating the net force in the direction of the motion, and time is 3 seconds that is given. So for this, we are calculating the net force. So net force will be T, then this force, then you have minus 0.3 into R. So from this, we get an equation like this. Now consider the 1000 newton block. So you have the self weight, which is connected by two strings. Therefore, you have T and T. When you apply the impulse momentum equation, so the net force will be 1000 minus 2 into T into 3. So from this, when you apply this equation, you get another equation like this. So when you solve this equation and the previously obtained equation, we get the velocity of the block A is 4.71 meter per second, and the velocity of the block B is 2.36 meter per second, and also the tension in the string is 459.97 newton. Now this is another problem. So you have a block which is resting on an inclined plane, and you have a applied force P which is acting at an angle of 15 degree with the horizontal. So you have to find the velocity of the block after 5 seconds. Again, you draw the free body diagram of this block. So you have the self weight 80 newton, which is resolved into two components, 80 sin 35 and 80 cos 35, where 35 is the angle of inclination of the plane. Then this inclined force also can be resolved into two components. One is 75 cos 15, another one is 75 sin 15. So that is the difference here. Then you have the normal reaction R. And it is like this block is resting on a smooth plane, therefore there is no frictional force. So you have to note that. So coefficient of friction is also not given, because the block is resting on a smooth plane, therefore you don't have the frictional force here. So simply we are going to apply the impulse momentum equation for this block. So for this, we are going to get the net force in the direction of the motion. So the direction of the motion will be in this direction. Therefore, if you calculate the net force, which is 75 cos 15 minus 80 sin 35, that is the net force acting in the direction of the motion. So into the time, 5 seconds, which will be equal to m into v minus u, u is equal to 0. So from this, we get the final velocity is 16.29 meter per. So with this, we complete the principle of impulse and momentum, and we have seen a number of problems on solving the kinetics of particles using the principle of impulse and momentum. Now, so far we have discussed three methods. One is D'Alembert's principle. The second one is the principle of work and energy. The third one is principle of impulse and momentum. So in the D'Alembert's principle, we consider the inertia force also while solving the problems. So here, this D'Alembert's principle can be used for solving kinetic problems when you have the force and acceleration involved in the system. Whereas in the second principle called work energy principle, we have used the work energy equation, which is nothing but the work done is equal to the change in kinetic energy. So here, work energy principle can be used for solving problems when you have force, velocity and displacement involved in the system. And in the third method, which we have seen in this lecture, that is principle of impulse and momentum. So this principle is used for solving kinetic problems when you have force, time and velocity. So here we make use of impulse momentum equation, that is impulse is equal to change in momentum, for solving the problems. So this is a comparison of different methods of solving kinetics problems. So with this we come to the end of this particular lecture, and for this lecture I have used these two books as the references. Thank you.